Hi, I'm Lori Grunin, senior editor for CNET, and this is the Olympus Pen EP3. I really wanted to love this camera. I mean, really. Olympus's Pen line has frequently delivered great photo quality and well-designed cameras, albeit with poor performance. While the company delivers great performance in this model, while maintaining its design and feature strengths, it seems to have taken a step back on photo and video quality. I don't think there's anything wrong with the camera that can't be fixed by a firmware update, but for its high price, I expect better photo quality out of the box. The camera body is about the same size as the EPL2. Though it's still an attractive, sturdy, all-metal body, the black model at least feels and looks a bit more plasticky than its predecessor, and than the other colors. In the box, Olympus includes an optional shallow grip that screws in if you don't like the feel of the flat front, and you'll be able to buy a deeper grip as well. That should make it easier to shoot with longer or original 4/3 lenses. Olympus updates the camera with a 3-inch OLED touchscreen display. It's a really nice LCD. It's bright and saturated, it's fingerprint proof, and you can choose whether to display colors as natural or vivid. Though it's a touchscreen, only part of the interface takes advantage of it. That includes touch shutter and the live guide. The camera retains the solid control layout of its predecessor. There's now a movie record button on the back. It's in a good place for thumb-based operation, but in order to prevent accidental presses, there's a lip around it, which makes it hard to press, even intentionally. There are now two customizable function buttons, but I think they carry a little too much of the interface burden. For instance, in order to use custom settings, you've got to assign them to a function button, and you have to hold the button down while shooting. So in order to shoot with a custom burst set, which is on one function button, plus a JPEG override for JPEG plus RAW, which is on the other button, I ran out of fingers. The camera also has its typical, really nice creative feature set. Without the ability to view the RAW files, it's hard to make a judgment about the camera's optimal noise level, and the EP3 complicates it by defaulting to what I think are overly aggressive noise reduction settings for JPEGs. You can see the detail start to degrade between ISO 400 and 800 and spot color noise at ISO 1600. My out-of-the-box shots at ISO 400 were kind of disappointing, especially given that I shot them with the expensive new 12mm lens. But scaling back the noise reduction to low, or even turning it off entirely, produces much better results. The photos are grainier, but it's not an unattractive look, and it preserves a lot more detail. I suspect that shooting RAW processing with better noise reduction software will gain you at least a stop of latitude of grain. The EP3's color rendering looks quite accurate and pleasantly saturated. It helps that the camera defaults to a neutral image style. It also seems to underexpose a bit by default. However, Olympus takes a serious misstep when it comes to video. While it ups to full HD and offers a full set of manual exposure capabilities, the quality's terrible. There's egregious rolling shutter. You know, that jello wobbling that appears with the slightest camera movement. I think it might be fixable in firmware, though. One way in which the EP3 unambiguously outdoes its predecessors is standard shooting performance. As a result, the Pen series has gone from sluggish to one of the fastest in its competitive class, faster overall than all the other mirrorless ILCs, about the same as Sony's fixed mirror SLT models, and just a bit slower than comparably priced DSLRs. For what it delivers, the EP3 is quite expensive, especially since the new models expected in the fall are supposed to have the same performance and sensor. Even if they're not as fast, they'll probably be fast enough. Once I get RAW software, and if Olympus possibly tweaks the defaults, I may boost the image rating, and the camera might rise in my estimation. But if you're looking for a sleek model that delivers superb image quality, spend the extra $200 on a Fujifilm X100. If you instead want a solid step up from a point-and-shoot, I'd wait and see what arrives in the second half of the year. I'm Lori Grunin, and this is the Olympus Pen EP3.